Microsoft is very worried that so many people are still using Windows 10 despite end of support coming next year in October 2025. So much so that they did something that they have never done before. You see, anytime a major version of Windows goes out of support, like for Windows 7, happened with Windows 8, and now Windows 10, Microsoft offers usually 3 years of so-called extended security updates that companies can usually buy, though it gets kind of expensive, but normally individuals cannot buy this. You have to buy it through like volume licensing, but that's where something is changing, and I'll get to that in a second. For Windows 10, for example, companies can get the first year of the extended security updates, or ESU, for $61, and then it doubles every year after that, and it maxes out at 3 years. You can't actually buy it past 3 years. But not only does it double in price, but it's cumulative. So if you don't get the first year of updates, but then you decide at the second year to get it, you actually have to buy the first year anyway, so you end up paying like $180 regardless. And the same as if you do it for the 3 years. And the whole point of this is to incentivize companies to just bite the bullet and upgrade their systems instead of buying the security updates, which just gets more and more expensive. But at the same time, have that option if they absolutely need to as like a stopgap bridge until then. However, for the first time ever, Microsoft announced that individuals will be able to buy personal system extended security updates for $30, actually. So they've never done this before. Before, you could only buy, like for the Windows 7 one in 2020, you could only get it through volume licensing. Though it seems like they might not be planning to do this for the full 3 years. The blog post where they mention this just says 1 year. However, on another post, they mention it as an annual subscription, so they might be thinking about whether to make it longer. They're probably still deciding. Now, like the name suggests, these security updates are not going to include any kind of feature updates. In fact, I don't think Windows 10 has been getting feature updates for the last several years, so it's not really going to change there. And also, it's not going to be all security updates, though it's going to be a vast majority of them. They specifically say it's going to be for critical and important security severity levels. They have an article where they go into detail for what these mean. For example, critical vulnerabilities are ones that don't require user interaction, and the important severity means the system can get compromised even with the user like clicking a warning or something like that. So that definitely, I think, would cover a lot. And then there's some lower tier ones like moderate and low severity, which seem to just be ones that are either not vulnerable by default, like you have to have some kind of setting that you change from default. And also, especially for low, they don't even necessarily recommend enabling it. They say more like if it makes sense for you. Now, I should point out there's an exception for the Windows 10 LTSC or long-term servicing channel versions of Windows. These actually have extended support until 2029 or 2027, depending on the version. However, Windows LTSC, you probably don't want to be using these. That's more for special purpose computers that have a single purpose. They don't really need to rely on external software, because the thing is, if you use LTSC, it doesn't get any feature updates, but it's also like staying on a really old version of Windows that doesn't get any kind of updates. And for example, the 2019 one, a lot of software that you use might not even support that anymore. So yeah, it's still getting security updates, but it might not work as well as you think. Now, as for why Microsoft is doing this, well, if you look at the statistics for how many people are using Windows 10 still, it becomes a little bit more obvious. Now, it's gonna depend where you look. There's two sources that I found. One is on StatCounter. For September 2024, it says Windows 10 has a market share of 63%. And Windows 11 is only 33%. The other source that I looked at was the Steam Hardware Survey, which shows that Windows 10 and Windows 11 are about 50-50 actually split. Now, if we look at the historical data for the Steam Hardware Survey, which I found on this GitHub repo, someone has been keeping track and just putting it all into a big Excel file. That's very convenient. I'll put a link in the description. And then I used ChatGPT to have it analyze using Python or whatever to generate graphs and stuff, so we can look at the actual historical data and compare it to Windows 7 at the time. Now, keep in mind, this big spike here apparently was a bug in how Steam was tracking Windows 7 market share, so just ignore that big spike. But we can see that in 2020, when Windows 7 went out of support, right before, it was roughly around like 20% or so. Not nearly as high as Windows 10 is right now. Now, Windows 7 did have a big drop-off right after it went out of support, but it didn't go to zero or anything, and it actually kind of drifted off still. But even though Windows 10 share is drifting downwards, it's not drifting down very slowly, and it looks like it might be around like 40% by the time it gets to end of life support, and that is such a huge number. And that's, again, only the Steam hardware survey, which is probably going to have people who tend to keep their system more up to date anyway, because a lot of games require more recent versions of Windows. So like the general public probably is still using a majority of Windows 10. I wouldn't be surprised, especially considering all the talk about the hardware requirements. If you're using a device that is older, then like you haven't even been able to use Windows 11. So I would not be surprised if that's the reason Microsoft decided, we better offer these extended security updates. It's kind of like a halfway option between just extending the support, which they probably really don't want to do, and just offering it for like $30. So they can kind of say, well, you can buy it if you want, but really they don't want people to. Now, I was curious, like what percentage of all the security updates are these important or critical level? Like what kind of coverage are you actually getting if you get the security updates? And it seems like actually a lot of them. So Microsoft actually has a page where they post a list of all the security updates that happen every month. It's called Patch Tuesday, second Tuesday of the month. I'll put a link to this page in the description. It's called the Security Update Guide. And you can filter just for Windows and then even download the data and then like analyze it in Excel. So I downloaded the ones since the beginning of the year, and it shows that there's around 12,000. However, that's a bit misleading because each CVE, which is like a unique identifier per vulnerability, each version of Windows is gonna have their own entry. So when I filtered down for one unique entry per exploit, there's about 600 of them for this year, and that still is a lot. And it looks like a vast majority of them are the important category. And then there's a handful of ones that are marked as critical or moderate severity. Or if we download the data just filtered for Windows 10, 64-bit, then it shows there's around 350 since the beginning of the year. And that's around like 30 per month. So that still is a lot. But anyway, it shows that, all right, at least if you do get the extended security updates, you're getting a vast majority of the security updates that you would want. I will quickly mention though, that in the past, Microsoft has on very rare occasions, actually only two that I'm aware of, released emergency patches for very old versions of Windows. In 2017 and 2019, they released emergency patches going back to Windows XP and newer versions. And at the time, Windows XP went out of support in 2014. And these were specifically for some vulnerabilities related to some exploits that the NSA developed. And then 3 years later, there were some exploits that were wormable that were highly exploited, which means like they could spread without any user interaction and very quickly through networks. So I guess they decided that was severe enough to just go back and patch like everything, but don't rely on that because again, that literally has only happened twice as far as I'm aware. But I would be curious if any of you are gonna consider getting the extended security updates for that extra year, or are you just gonna upgrade to Windows 11? Maybe you can't depending on your system. What are you thinking? I would say personally, Windows 11 really is not bad. It's a decent operating system. Really the worst thing about it is the annoyances. Like it requires you to use a Microsoft account to log in unless you like do a bunch of workarounds, which I do. It's just little stuff like that. Of course, you might strongly prefer Windows 10. You might like the start menu. I know I liked the start menu in Windows 10 better, so I installed a third-party program to make the start menu in Windows 11 looked like that, so I don't blame you. Anyway, if you enjoyed the video, be sure to give it a big giant thumbs up for the YouTube algorithm, and also maybe consider subscribing. I do make other videos. For example, if you want to keep watching, last time I made a video talking about breaking the Windows clipboard by adding a whole bunch of stuff to it, and it kind of messes stuff up, so I'll put that link right there you can click on. So thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.